To understand where in our view controller we can write this code, we need to investigate our class. You will notice that it inherits from another class called UIViewController, which is a class Apple wrote for managing views. Let me unpack this relationship with the help of a diagram. So we know that the view in our app comprises of things like buttons and labels, and that this view is controlled or managed by a file called viewController.swift. Now this file has a class in it by the same name, and this class inherits from UIViewController. UIViewController has several functions defined within it that we also inherit. One of them is called viewDidLoad. This is called when our view is first created. This function is great for any initial setup or any one-time only work that we want to do in our app. By the way, if you go back to the code, you will notice that there is a skeletal version of this method viewDidLoad, which was created when we first made our project. Another function we inherit is called viewWillappear. This function is called right before the view appears to the user, and it's a great place for showing and hiding different things on our screen. Next on the list is viewDidAppear. This function is called right after the view appears to the user and is a great place for starting any animations. There are a few more functions like these. Two of them are viewWillDisappear and viewDidDisappear. I've added a link in the instructor notes that provides more details about all of these. By the way, don't take my word for the existence of any of these functions. Let's go back to Xcode and check for documentation. Here, I can press and hold the Option key on my keyboard and then click on UIViewController to get some documentation on this class. If you actually want to see the code inside this class UIViewController, what you can do is press and hold Command on your keyboard and then click on the class name. Xcode will now show you the code inside UIViewController. Here, you can check to see all of the methods inside UIViewController, like viewDidLoad, viewWillAppear, and the rest. Once you're done reading through this code, you can go back to your own class by clicking this back button here. Okay, so here I am at the question I asked previously. Now that we know a little bit more about these functions that run at different times in the life of a view, let's think about this question one more time. If you wanted to write this piece of code to hide the stop button, which method would you write this in?